Hi there. My name is Gary, and I'm about to start a new playthrough of Fallout 4. I've already finished the game. Steam says I've played for over 350 hours, so I've saved the Commonwealth already, met all of the factions, finished all of the DLCs, well, except for the last one, Nuka World, the one DLC that was put out that allowed players to be evil if they wanted to. I ultimately found it very distasteful, so I didn't finish Nuka World, but I finished all the other DLCs. And now, I want to start a new playthrough that will hopefully give me something new out of the game. Now, Bethesda, the game company that makes the Fallout games, does not really have a great reputation for the quality of their game's overarching narratives. That means that I often find their small quests very fun, but the main quest, the main thing that your character is supposed to do, is often ridiculous, poorly written, and ultimately unsatisfying. Those of you who played Fallout 3, remember the water purifier in the Jefferson Memorial? Yeah. So, I knew I wanted to play Fallout 4 again, and I wanted to start over and mainly ignore the badly written main quest entirely, ignore the factions, and make my own story in this world. Travel around with a chosen companion, and enjoy the richness of the world's side quests and the accidental adventures out there in the Commonwealth. So I decided to use downloadable mods in order to make that happen, to give me the options I want in the game, and to get rid of what I don't want. And unfortunately, one thing I don't want that Bethesda forces me to have is standing right behind me, my wife. Fallout 4 forces you to start off playing the game as a straight person in a different sex marriage. Now, I'm not a straight person, and I have no desire to play as one. And if you're like me, to require this is an unfortunate, limiting decision made by Bethesda right at the start of the game. Also, I can have some character motivation that actually is often ignored for the sake of going out and adventuring, and also for an underwhelming late-game shocking reveal of an NPC's identity that really actually isn't all that shocking. And this forced relationship is so deeply coded into how Bethesda wants you to play this game that mods have to jump through so many complex hoops to even try and give you the freedom of not starting off as a straight character. So it's easier to actually just try and ignore this beginning altogether. And I actually found a new mod recently released that will allow me to do just that. To start off as the kind of character I want to be, and ignore all this beginning part. So let me finish tweaking my appearance, and I'll show you what I mean. Here's my handsome mug. I often spend a lot of time on character creation. It's one of my favorite parts of games like this. So now that I've got myself pretty much the way I want him to look, confirm the character. No turning back now. And I'll let some of these mods load in the background. Now normally the game starts here in the pre-apocalypse part. And takes you forward into the post-apocalypse part of the game. But this is the mod that allows me to skip all of that and actually not play as this married straight person. So I get to choose a couple options here. I'm going to choose that I was in the Commonwealth. And let me put my attribute points in. Start off with just a baseline of everything, and I tend to normally play sneaky sniper characters, ones that hang back and use sniper rifles, so give myself a lot of agility, a lot of intelligence to learn skills, and perception. I'm going to use Jespar as a name. It's my current favorite character in another game. Enderal, if you don't know that, you should. It's a total conversion mod for Skyrim, also made by Bethesda. Now with this mod, it allows me to have some unique traits. I'm not going to choose any unique traits. Instead, I'm going to choose the kind of person I am that will just put me out in the middle of the Commonwealth. I'm going to choose a scout that allows me to skip this beginning part and play as my own character. So the scout usually starts off out in the middle of the Commonwealth in Boston. I guess I'm going to have to figure out a unique trait or see if I can just change. All right, that's all safe. That's fine. Can I choose no traits? Okay, yes, I can choose no traits. I'm not going to do any of the special ones. And I'm ordinary. I'm just fine. That's good. Chosen to have no traits. That's fine. I think I'll probably have to choose these again. All right, choose scout again. I'm random person on a scouting mission. And I'm monitoring Quincy out there in the Commonwealth. All right, now ready to wake up. That's the way this mod does it, is it says, this is all a dream. You being a married straight person, yours is just a dream. Let's get to your real life. All right, so here I am, starting off in the middle of the Commonwealth, on my own, level one. This is the starter gear they give you as a scout. Nothing special. But literally, I am in the middle of the Commonwealth, with nothing else around. Yeah, the Commonwealth is quite big. Alright, so I've also installed two mods. One is a shopping mod, and another one is a player house. I think the goal for now is to get up to that player house. And to get to some safety. So I can start to figure out how I'm going to get around. Now, what have they given me? A machete and a rifle with 6 bullets. Not a whole heck of a lot. So I'm going to have to really be careful. Oh, another pistol. Okay, at least I've got another pistol. Yeah, I should probably take everything around here. I have no money, so I'm going to need to sell everything I can when I get to a trader. Well, whoever was here first had a lot of dogs. Or cats. Alright, super sneaky sniper time. I'm a level 1 character in the middle of a very dangerous place. Let's start with the rifle. Get a little bit of the lay of the land, and then start to make my way north to that player house. As you can hear from the random gunfire, this is a very dangerous place. There's Quincy down there. That's the town I was supposedly monitoring as a scout, but now it's time to leave and make my way home. Alright, I'm going to assign my weapons to hotkeys to make things quicker. Since I don't have many bullets, I might have to switch between these two guns at a moment's notice. Or take out the machete for hand-to-hand combat if I need to. So, grab whatever I can as I go along. Right off the bat, we got some ghouls over there in the town, so I'm going to stay well clear of the town. Ghouls tend to flock together, and as a newly born first level character, I cannot take on a pack of ghouls, that's for sure. So I'm just going to try and sneak by without them seeing me. Probably not. Don't want to go up that way. Just stick to the overgrowth areas. Just let nobody see me. Oh, got some smoke up ahead. That's probably not good. No, that's definitely not good. It's a raider camp. They also flock together. I can't take an entire raider camp on alone. So I'm gonna give them some roots. Oh, we got some more ghouls. Over by the abandoned car there. So, I have to make a choice between the ghouls and the raiders. I think the ghouls are probably an easier target. One good thing about ghouls is if you can get a drop on them, you can usually take them out quite quickly. But something has seen me, or knows that I'm here. So I'm getting the caution message in my sneaking around. Give it a moment. It's probably the ghouls, because I'm closer to the ghouls than the raiders, I think. I might still be able to get the drop on them. Take out these two ghouls very quickly. Three ghouls! Okay. Take that one out. Take it down. Dodge! Switch to my machete really quickly. Nice. Ghouls are a bit radioactive. That's why they are ghouls in the first place, so... Just getting a little bit of radiation damage from him when he died. Do you have anything worth taking? No, some bottle caps. That's fine. I only remember killing two ghouls. There was a third one. Where'd he go? Oh, there he is. Alright. Line him up. Early. There we go. Take him out from the back. And one more for good measure. Alright. So back to hidden. Whew. Took out three ghouls on my own. Oh. Got big mutant bear there. And I definitely cannot take out a big mutant bear. I'm surprised I could take out three ghouls. That was something. Alright, I'm just gonna run. Try and thread my way between the bear and the raiders. So far so good, still hidden. Very unhealthy area. Get away from the radiation. Get away from the radiation. Okay, we don't want to go out there. Something is going on over there. We don't want to... It's kind of the way we need to go, but let's stay away from whatever the heck is happening over there. And just try and stay off of everybody's radar. Yeah, we got some things fighting each other over there. Let's stay over here. Alright, we're coming up. Looks like we're coming up behind a gas station. Maybe there's some stuff here we can loot. Those explosions are really disconcerting. They are off the distance. That's a good thing. That one sounded a bit closer. Hope whatever's going on out there just stays out there while I loot this abandoned gas station. So far, it's an abandoned gas station full of junk. But hopefully, I'll be able to see a trader eventually and sell the junk off. Those gunshots sound awfully close. Anything in the newsstand or the garbage can? Nope. Let's check the bus real quick, and then let's get out of here. Nope. No loot, just junk. Alright, so we gotta go further north into the city itself. Which is probably gonna be not all that easy. It is only a couple blocks on the map, but the urban environment tends to be densely packed with hostile things that want to shoot at me. So let's see how this goes. Alright, I did some scouting over to the left there, and that area is just full of hostiles, so I'm going to go around a bit to the right here and see if I can make my way across this highway area in front of me. This collapsed highway, actually, is what it is. And see if I can get further into the city that way. Excuse me, Mr. Tub Skeletons. Let me grab your junk. That didn't sound good. Make my way through the bombed out suburbs of Boston. Oop, didn't mean to get up the tree. Usually if you go around the water area, you might find a passageway through. Well, actually I see a passage over there. I can make my way across over here and go up on the other side. I see a wooden building in the distance there. That's probably raiders. Don't want to go anywhere near that. Just go across over here. What? Oop! What? Somebody's around here. And somebody's not friendly around here. I'm just going to leg it. Head up this collapsed on-ramp. Oh, somebody still sees me. Thankfully they're not shooting. I'm definitely getting closer into the town. That's good. I still got a couple blocks to go though. Head up here and see if I can... Actually, going up is not really what I want to do. I want to actually go further down. But a bit disconcerted by the fact that somebody's still seeing me. I don't know if those bullets are aimed at me or not, but I'm not going to take any chances. Yep, there's somebody up ahead. Alright, maybe it's time to just go down. Get down off this on-ramp. Obviously somebody's shooting at somebody. They didn't see me. That's good. Alright, still need to get over there. I'll put a marker there. That'll kind of help me keep it in view on the radar at the bottom of the screen. Whoop, don't want to go down that way. That's a long drop. Thinking I can get across over here. Yeah, I can make this jump. And try and get down, back down to ground level. Yeah, I probably don't want to go across there. See if there's some stairs on the other side. Oh, yes, there is. I'll head down these stairs, get back down to ground level. That sounds like a sensible plan. Alright, I'm parkouring my way down this building, and more gunfire has erupted around me. Not at me, That's a plus. I'll just wait for it to subside a little bit. Alright. Try and make my way down. Bit of a long drop. Alright. Not really the direction I need to go. I need to go this way. But, that's a raider enclave. Don't want to go that way. That guy that way. Don't want to go that way. No. Yeah, I'm going to have to go this way. Make my way around the block. It's very easy to get turned around in the urban parts of Boston. Because everything's bombed out and broken, everything looks the same. I find it very easy to get... lose my bearings. Alright, getting closer. Somebody's got their radio on nearby. Hey, Boston Common. Found a major landmark. Major landmarks usually have major baddies in them, so be careful. Make my way around the edges here. As quietly as I can. Something bad went down here. Let's give this a wide berth as well, too. Oh, nice, a bookstore. Wish it was open. Grab all this, grab the hard hat. Grab the shovel to sell it on. We should more or less be here. One of these buildings here. Check inside this real quick. Oh, so right away, that'll help. Get rid of the radiation. And we'll just leave the bones. And there it is. We've made it. Oh, it looks nice from the outside. Got some nice lights around it. There's a power suit area. Power armor station. Odd that it's outside, but alright. Nothing immediately hostile. Let's go have a look inside. I'm going to use this as my home base for this character. I've not been here before. I've only seen pictures of the inside, and pictures do it justice. It's very nice. Yeah, let's turn off the radio. Very nice. I wouldn't really have chosen silver leather sofas, but it seems to work, what's to say. That's good enough. Some armor racks. That's good. Weapon racks, bobblehead shelves. Really nice attention to detail. The mod maker really did a good job. I'll put links to all the mods I use in the description of the videos, so if you want to check out them on your own, you can. Cooking stove, good. Espresso machine, a must. All very nice and clean for post-apocalyptic world. That's very good. Let's throw some clothes on our naked mannequins here. Now I've got, basically got that and a hard hat. We'll start with that. T to activate. There we go. Let's check out upstairs. Got a weapons workbench. Whoa, lots of weapons. Fortunately, can't take any of them off the walls. They're just decoration. More armor racks. Really nice. A lot of storage. That's really good. Armor bench, chemistry lab. Really liking the storage. Oh, and a very nice bathroom. I like the candles by the tub. Very nice touch. Oh, somebody left me some medicine. That's good. Oh, I can even change my appearance in the mirror. All in all, a very good house. I can see myself really liking staying here. And the windows, the lighting that comes in through the windows should be ambient as well too, with the day-night cycle, which is always good. Alright, so here we are. We're starting my new life in Fallout 4 at my new house on my own. We'll see if we can change that up next episode. So, thanks for watching. Hope you'll join me in this new adventure, and see you later.